Howdy ding dong doodly guys, welcome back to Let's Play Danganronpa.
Cheer epic Havoc!
With me, TapersCrazy. Well, let's lift off, we completed the last case, and it was absolutely insane, man, how much thinking you had to do with that stuff, but I think it was easier than me, definitely the last one. I don't know why, I just seemed to, like, hit all the right notes or something. I guess I was just being a bit more open-minded as I was investigating, but today we're gonna see what the fallout of all this is, so let's continue on. A strange sound rang out through my head. I felt like it was shaking my brain back and forth. And then, darkness. Oh yes, we got attacked by El Luchador as well, didn't we? Don't understand what's happening. Don't know what started it. It's all over. Game over, man! Game over! Wrong film! And with that, I opened my eyes. Didn't know how long it had been. Oh shit, everything's gone. Ow. Apparently something hit me, and I lost consciousness. That's all I understood. The dull throbbing pain in my head proved that much at least. Oh, they've taken everything. Shit. Okay. Okay, so it looks like someone wants to cover this whole place up. An empty bookshelf. Huh? Empty? Gone. It's all gone. The yearbook, the student registry, and even the note that had fallen on the floor. It's all gone? What does this mean? My brain refused to do any more work. An insistent pain in my head began to spread across the rest of my body. For now. Yeah, concussions are very dangerous things, so if you start feeling sick, you should probably see a doctor, but I guess we haven't got one of those. Should go back to my room. Get some rest. Because I've heard some major stories about concussion. Really, really bad. My body was heavy with pain, my mind heavy with thought. I dragged myself back toward my room. Somehow, I made it back to the first floor of the school. The further I walked, the more I felt. Things are getting blurry. Can't see in front of me. I couldn't stop myself from collapsing right there. And after that... As if from a vast distance, I heard a sound. Oh no, Optimus Prime! He's back! It was faint, but undeniable. The sound. It's coming from... the gym? As I desperately hauled my shaky frame towards the gym, the sound got stronger and stronger. What's going on? Can't be nothing. Here. In the gym. It's just Sakura lifting weights.
Get out, impotent fool.
Didn't make a sound as they opened the door to the gym. The sound's coming from inside, meanwhile, only intensified that much more.
Back here.
What on earth is going on? Holy shit! Sakura vs Monokuma. Before me, they raged about beyond anything humanely possible. One side's not human, that's for sure. But regardless, I couldn't stop staring. I forgot to move even.
Why, you? What do you think you're doing?
Is Sakura a robot? Look at that bloody blue eyeball.
What's the meaning of this?
Yeah, you're not supposed to hit him, he'll kill you.
How dare you defy me? This wasn't part of the deal!
Deal? The deal.
I've made a decision. I will no longer retreat. No longer compromise.
Wait,
no,
what's going on?
Regret. I've made my decision. I'm going to resist you.
What? What is going on?
But... you do realize what will happen if you go through with this, right? You haven't forgotten, have
he's probably going to kill her. Don't do that.
I'm holding hostage?
What am I looking at? What am I hearing? A hostage? Then, could it be the mastermind spies? Oh, shit. But that's blackmail, though. That's not fair. The next generation legend. Stand tall, galactic hero.
The end.
God, everyone's freaking dying, man. There's 7 of us left.
And I'm in the middle, because I'm the protagonist.
To be continued in this episode.
You receive a Super Robo Justice present. Oh, good for me, I guess. Don't save it. Yes. Okay, just like... I just save, like, iterative, like... Never save on the same file. It's like YouTube 101. Leon killed Sayaka. Monokuma killed Junko. Then Leon got executed. Then Mondo killed Chihiro. Then he got executed. Ifumi killed Taka, then Celeste killed Ifumi. And then she got executed. And that's where we're at, guys. Jesus Christ. That brings us up to now. Got so much death. The next morning in the dining hall, the day after Celeste's case.
So now there's only five of us here.
Only 30 more people we started with.
Indeed.
Illness has become commonplace.
That's true.
Still, I think we need to speak to Sakura. Did I see yesterday? Don't understand. Sakura is a mastermind spy. Can that really be true? There's something more to him.
Makoto, are you okay?
No, I'm fine. Can't bring it up in front of the others. If I did that, it would just confuse everyone that much more.
Okay.
Alright, Marcus, let's see till we pass out.
What do you mean, in that case?
Oh, look how scary everyone looks. It's gotta be because you're all fine on empty stomachs, right? If you feel way better, I'm sure it'll all cheer up. So let's eat.
Okay.
Let's grab some fish and donuts and need to start. Can't stand up.
Fish and donuts?
Someone likes the seaside.
That's like a deep impact style, meteor impact, extinction level and combination of foods.
Huh? What? Those are both breakfast time top sellers.
Still, the Tilly can't stand apart is a problem. After we're done, we need to go explore.
I see.
That's right. Since the class tried this over, new areas should have opened up.
It's true.
Plus, we still have Alter Ego. We don't have to give it to Despatus yet.
She's right. We have to plan ahead and think about the future.
Yeah. Think happy thoughts, not deathly thoughts.
You know?
Like, when we're gonna get out of here, right?
Serious?
When this is all over, they're gonna get reborn for serious. Reborn as someone serious.
Well...
Hey, you okay? Sounds like something someone who's about to die would say.
Totally okay. I'm not gonna die. Why? Because there ain't gonna be any more murders.
Huh? What makes you so sure?
According to the spirits...
I predicted it last night. Since it revealed itself to me from ever, there's no doubt about
however.
It.
However...
How accurate is your fortune telling anyway?
How about that?
I can usually 20 or 30% on a good day.
That seems really low.
It's not like some occult mystery.
Yeah. It's not like it's ESP or whatever. Of course I'm only gonna get it right sometimes.
The occult is bullcrap!
I told you, my fortune telling isn't like some occult thing.
Fortune telling? Isn't a cult?
You got it all wrong!
Of course not. Clairvoyance is clairvoyance. Don't put it in the same category as cattle mutilation.
Cattle what?
So...
His friends have urban legend where aliens abduct cows and dissect them as part of their research.
Actually...
No. You're calling it an urban legend? As a matter of fact, it's true. As a matter of fact, it's happened to me.
Hmm.
It all happened one day when I went to go get a hamburger. I went out to my barn. An old base, it was just a sentence of a sky. I got my pitchfork on my... place I've never even been before. I claim my patties are 100% all beef. So I got a burger to go and headed home. Before long,
the end is nigh!
The sky was full of mysterious blinding light.
Some crazy being came out of nowhere and locked onto my hamburger.
What? This game is insane. You just executed someone, now you're getting hamburgers abducted by aliens.
And as soon as the beam touched it, the burger started floating in
midair. It's
mid-air.
The Burger King.
Don't eat at McDonald's. Ooh.
And then, still floating there, the entire burger started coming apart. One part of it just vanished.
What has he been smoking?
The rest fell back into my hand. Do you realize what that means? It means the burger wasn't 100% beef. It must have had some pork or something mixed in. Something like 70% pork and 30% beef would be my guess.
What is going on? What? I should have hung around with Hagakur, really. That would have been intense.
So I stormed mine into the burger place and got up in my manager's grill. They totally admitted it. It wasn't 100% beef. They totally mixed in ground pork with
it. How about that?
Now do you see? That is cow mutilation.
I kind of got lost halfway through.
Can't tell if you're off your collar against it. You stink of stupidity.
Don't be mean.
I stink of... How dare you?
Well, you do stink, though.
That's fine.
That's fine.
Anyway, hope your prediction turns out to be true.
Well, at the very least, I won't murder anyone.
Yeah.
Me either. I would never.
Of course.
Me either.
Indeed.
Oh, no, right.
Goes for me too, of course. I'd never kill any of my friends. I feel like those words of encouragement were helping us come together as one.
Yeah, but people say that, don't they?
So much sacrifice and hardship, we finally become united. But,
well,
to be honest, I wish Byaki and Toko were here for this too.
But
they're so hard to deal with. They only think about themselves.
Yeah, we're better off without them, I say.
Well, there's enough to prove we're united for the time being, but within that bond, hid weakness and fragility.
God, that's insane.
We began our search as soon as we finished our breakfast in the dining hall. We'd find out what opened up what was waiting for us.
Stuff and things.
Okay, let's go have a look around then. Actually, I want to go see if I can get to the monastery and get some new stuff. So let's just have a quick mosey on over there. And then, if I can't get in there, I'll just like cut back to you when I get back to... whenever all the stuff, I'm gonna spend all the mono coins. Okay, I'll cut back to you in a sec.
Okay, now I've got about 170 million items I'm carrying around. Now I've just got like, imagine, Naegi just like hoarding around a full sack of stuff. Like, you know, when you see like pictures online of like, Dovahkiin with like a sack of stuff and he's carrying around, like, just imagine that, but that's Naegi. I think I've got like enough to keep everyone happy, to be honest, because I've got like a 95% repeat rate, so I think I've got a present for everyone, if I'm honest, and enough to repeat over and over again. So let's just go find the stairs, which I can't rightly remember where they are, so sort of wander around. Yeah, this is one thing that happened, like a lot of other YouTubers cut sort of this walking around stuff, but I'd like to see where, I'd like to see the outline of all the entire buildings. So now we have access to the 4th floor of Oak Speed Academy. Maybe this time we'll find some kind of clue. No, this time I have to find it. Find it, okay. Lady's toilet. Okay, let's have a nice wander around as we normally do. We'll probably like get into like a triggered cutscene before we get to explore everything, as in what happens every single time. So, because this is pretty much blind at this point. Like, this is a bit of a let's play where I stopped paying attention to what was going on. Come on, it's rattle. No good. The door's locked. Guess I won't be getting in here. According to the nameplate, this is called the data center. What's behind the door is a total mystery. It's kind of good that it's locked, because like a data center is like... I know for our company, you need to have a certain certification before you can enter a data center, because it's like top secret stuff going on in there. Very, very important that things be kept secret. And I guess Monokuma's got something in there that isn't what's finding out. Hey, Hagakure. I'm glad this floor got open up and all, but it's like a ton of lot of rooms up here.
Is there? I've not really looked around yet, so...
Who'd you wait up here before me?
So I'm looking for B. 4B or not 4B? I always find it weird that classrooms have windows on like the inside of a building so people can look inside the classroom. Never made sense to me. It just seems like distracting to me when I'm trying to study and then there's some toffee nose pillar making noises and stuff as he's passing by the window. Okay, let's have a quick look at the This there's a mono bear there, which must mean that that's is that gonna be Monokuma's control room or something? I guess. I don't know. Okay, music. In a strange area, I would say. Oh my god, rock concert much. Hello, kitty kitty. This is the music room. Sadly, even a classroom is more like an actual concert hall. Well, it's like the ultimate school, isn't it?
Hey, you know, you haven't told me what you think yet.
What I think?
I have a secret room in a boys' bathroom.
Ah. Well, I did find the secret room, but... As soon as I started looking around, I was attacked.
What? Attacked? By who?
Well, they came from behind and I didn't have any time to react, so I didn't see who it was. When I came to, the mountains of files and documents were all gone. I'm sorry. I know how important those were.
It's okay. I already saw what I needed to be in there. The house spit of the mastermind might come after you.
What?
Because...
When I discovered the room, the mastermind must have seen me on the surveillance camera in the hallway. Must have seen me go into the boys' bathroom and not come out again. Still, I wanted you to go and see it. I wanted to see how the mastermind would react.
Whoa, making me a pawn in the game. I don't like that idea.
Essentially, I would have found out if the mastermind actually knew about that room.
It would seem...
But to attack you and steal everything in the room, just me And there was some unknown clue in there that could reveal the mastermind's identity.
Then, you know I was going to get
that
us up.
Doesn't matter.
Kind of that kind of thing, though, right? After all, you're a boy.
Rude! If you think a boy is, fine, I understand. Let me ask you something else. Do you know about Vanova that was left in there? Vanova said you must not leave.
Just a second.
We shouldn't talk about that. Not here.
Kiko stole a quick glance at the surveillance camera.
I'm looking into it. If I find out of anything, I'll let you know.
Listen to me.
Is that okay?
She made it sound like she was asking, but it was clear I wouldn't have any say in the matter.
So, let's hear your secret.
Huh?
Who do you think I would notice? You're hiding something.
Am I wrong?
But that's... Kirigiri.
What?
What's the matter? If you're worried about the camera, why not just write it down?
Well...
Hey.
We're friends, so you should be able to trust me. Isn't that what you said before?
You're right, but there shouldn't be any secrets between friends, but... No one's expressing doubt about your friend when you don't have evidence for it. Let's be honest. I don't have conclusive evidence yet. So about now, it could just make this...
Why are you even bother giving me the truth?
Friends shouldn't keep secrets, but there's no way I'm expressing that. Wow, Gabe, you are such an asshole. Sorry, I can't tell you. Not yet.
Correct.
So, what's your answer?
However,
do you think that's fair? You have to hear what I had said, but now you're willing to share.
I'm sorry, I really am.
That's fine. Goodbye.
God damn it, game. I trust Kirigiri. If it was a parting words, Kyoko left me standing there alone. I think I made her mad. Oh, freaking cock block. Look at that. Is this a grand piano? Seems really old, but it's worth a lot of money. Of course, without someone around who can play it, it's totally useless.
It's worth 3 monocoins.
Of which I am going to spend later. Probably after the trial or something. So let's... Okay, but Kirigiri keeps secrets as well, so I don't understand why she's getting all pissy. We're supposed to trust each other, man. And again, the game's forcing my hand. What?
Flowers!
This is the office. Of course, there's no hint of any teachers that we normally be able to rely on. Oh, I see. There's freaking flowers everywhere, man. Nice goosey gun around. There's a flower over there, so it makes things feel that much weirder. It does, doesn't it? It's like... flowers.
The symbol of hope.
I guess. I don't know. Wow. For every single flower, there is a monocoin. There's a flower on the desk. And monocoin. Jesus, I'm getting so much dollar. Okay, is it really going to give me monocoins for every single... I saw a picture on the floor there. Jesus Christ, man. I just spent all these. That's not a picture on the floor. I'm going to look at if Monokuma's going to come and snatch it off us. Just as Monokuma does. Okay, use your camera and monitor. Huh? There's a picture on the floor. This picture. Wait, what? What? Celeste, Hifumi, and Sayaka. Smiling the face of 3 people who are dead now. Casting without metal plates over the windows. And the camera as well, which is, doesn't look as tattered. It's exactly the same. Just like that picture I saw before. There's no way this isn't important somehow.
Take it and hide it.
The smiling way to expect a normal teenager to smile. Just normal group of high schools in a normal school life. Can't possibly be able to smile like that in a world of despair like this. So does that mean this picture was taken before they ever came to Hope's Peak? Which would mean everyone in the picture knew each other before they got here. Including Sayaka? No, there's no way Monokuma did it.
It must be a fake!
You're a fake!
Monokuma popped out of nowhere and snatched a picture from my hand.
A forgery, Pop! What are you, a middle schooler? I think my moon landing was fake too! Come on!
Then, you say this picture is... real.
Hey,
There was such a thing as a Nobel Truth Prize! I take first, second, and fourth place!
Too bad!
Ask your first problem, not true. Ask your question.
Oh, I asked you a question. Is this picture real or is it fake?
Oh, Makoto, you're sort of split things in half, aren't you?
Hey,
It's no use. It's just no use. Try to split something that can't be split. Let him feel like your other one being split.
It's true.
The picture is real. No more, no less.
Without another word, Monokuma disappeared. So the picture is real. It's really real. If that's true...
If that's the case... Ace Attorney!
Okay... So when... Everyone knew each other before... What is this? What is going on in this game? I've been in here. Ooh, there's a fifth floor. This school's freaking tall. I suppose it is a city school. Not one of those fancy. Cyber room, the smell of medicine was oppressive. So this is a chem lab. I hope in here all this stuff doesn't do permanent damage.
A, B, C.
So you mackle a big shelf, and it's stocked with all kinds of medicine.
Ah, listen, Makoto. Just take a deep breath and calm down and listen to me.
Okay, Hina, just chill out.
There's all kinds of stuff we didn't have before. Vitamins, minerals, amino acids, creatine.
Okay.
And what? We even have protein.
What?
Protein Zyme X.
What's that?
A high quality protein drink. It's nothing like my cheap stool in the warehouse. It's connoisseur level.
Oh, yeah?
That's amazing. It's a gold mine. I'm a passive finance. Time to order some more prison.
Gold mine, huh? Okay. So, chemicals though. Pumping yourself with chemicals. You and Sakura seem too lost in deep or friendly conversation. I think what's going on with Sakura and the mastermind, but I can't mark it with Hina.
You need something?
No, it's nothing.
Sure. Kevin.
Sakura.
Sakura is lost in conversation with the
What is it, Makoto? Do you need something?
No, it's nothing.
Really? Well. Okay.
Okay, is there anything else? I think that's everything in here. I need to get Sakura on her own. Last place is this. With what I assume is the principal's office, headmaster.
The president's office. The Oval Office.
Nameplate on the door says headmaster's room. The headmaster's room. Must be something worthwhile in there.
Rattle, rattle.
The door's locked. Damn it. First, I ain't good look at things around here. I still have to think about. For now, I should head back to the dining hall and talk to the others.
Yes.
Not long after I got to the dining hall, the others began to trickle in. After a few minutes...
So, is this everyone?
Well then...
Okay, let's discuss what we all discovered.
Yeah, good idea.
Okay. She's gonna be mad. Kyoko? She's ignoring me.
Hey, Makoto. Does Kyoko seem upset to you? She's totally mad.
Yeah, it looks like it.
What's your deal?
That's your fault, isn't it? You must have something to her.
Oh, this is bad. Oh, God. Doghouse.
Little sheets of Venus has all windows on the fourth floor. None of them but Shinich.
In other words,
just like everyone else.
Escape from the fourth floor seems unlikely. Most to be expected, though.
I think Kyuki needs to stop being petty, though. I mean, she's acting like a child.
Found a couple of rooms on the fourth floor. Fully locked. The data center in the headmaster's room.
Headmaster's room? Sounds like I can't place to find some clues.
We can somehow unlock the door and get inside.
Who cares about a stupid lock? Should be no problem for World's Drive's Mr. Link to knock down one measly door.
Oh.
What was that? No, please, continue. Did you say I've got the nicest button of a black? The curviest section in town? Is that what you said?
What the heck? Oh, no, I didn't.
Hey.
And what did you say? Because I know you want to have my tearing down the door to the headmaster's room.
I'm
being... I don't have headmaster's door. What kind of war and education do you have to start
your teacher has...
That's my room, no. It is now, anyway.
Betrayal?
Are you afraid to bust it down? Seriously, don't want to piss me off. Do you have any idea how much material is in a single backpack?
No, I was just kidding. Please don't get mad.
I'm not mad!
Emoticon face.
What? You're totally mad!
What?
This is kinda
I assume I'll have to add a rule for this, but if you're gonna go around having those thoughts, I have no choice but to add to the school regulations.
Seriously.
Breaking a lot past part of it. Now let's ruin my jerks.
Okay. And we'll continue this in the next episode because I'm out of time for this one, so thanks for watching this, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, comment, subscribe, and I'll see you all
in the next video.